Flemish cartographer Gerardus Mercator changed the view of the world through his maps in the 16th century. For him, maps were the eyes of history. Cartography and its evolution unveils the eagerness of man to understand and to make understood the world around him. Maps have helped explain this need. Maps, the eyes of history. From the sand sketches of the earliest civilizations to today's 3D maps, the history of cartography enables us to understand how humans have discovered, broadened, and transformed their view of the world over the centuries. Some of the atlases available in the BDH will allow us to draw this historical line. Found at the end of the 19th century, the Babylonian World Map is the oldest known map of the world to date. It's displayed in the British Museum and is considered the first map of the world. Written in cuneiform script, it's 2,500 years old. The map is a diagram of Babylonian cosmology. The center of the world represented in this tablet is Babylon, the cradle of civilization. Anaximander's lost map is, in addition to the first world map in cartographic history, the first geographical contribution to scientific rationality, according to experts. The description made by famous Greek historian Herodotus allows us to know how this map was, since no copy of it is preserved. It's the first one that tries to establish proportionality to the known world. Visually, it's similar to the previous one in the rounded way in which it presents the world. Babylon is no longer at the center. The Mediterranean Sea, Greece, and the ancient kingdom of Israel take over. In the 2nd century BC, the first map of the world using a system of meridians was made. Eratosthenes of Cyrene divided the land into different regions, from north to south and from east to west. Ptolemy's map had a great influence on later cartography. His maps incorporate a system of latitudes and longitudes. They were reconstructed from the discovery of his manuscript, Geographia, digitized in the BDH. The Greek philosopher was the first cartographer in representing the world in a systemized way. We had to wait until medieval times to see geographical features represented. The geographer, Al-Idrisi, in his book, Tabula Rogeriana, began to depict the sea and the mountains. Another document to highlight with a strong ideological and religious charge is the map of Hereford, where the city of Jerusalem can be seen in the center. At the top, we see a pantocrator overlooking the world and the earthly paradise. We can also see figures of fantastic beings and classical elements. The map is preserved in the Cathedral of Hereford, a town in the west of England. The importance of the Holy City of Jerusalem in the Middle Ages is enormous. Many BDH documents, such as the world map of Biatus of Liabana, explain this. The first time that America is represented unequivocally is on a map in 1500. The document was produced in Cadiz. The map is in the Naval Museum of Madrid and is available in various documents of the BDH. It shows Eurasia, separated from America by the Pacific Ocean. South and North America are also represented as two autonomous continents. The map by Juan de la Cosa was made to present the new overseas discoveries to the Catholic monarchs. At the beginning of the 16th century, Diego Ribera made what is considered the first scientific map. The map has a clear influence of the trip around the world of Elcano and Magellan. The BDH has extensive and detailed documentation about these journeys. But the true winner was the world map of Gerardus Mercator. The document was published in 1569 and was a revolution in navigation from the 16th century onwards. Its great contribution to the cartographic study is evident in the important collection of Flemish Atlas, available in the BNE and the BDH. Again in the 16th century, the first atlas was published, the Theatrum Orbis Terrarum, written by Abraham Ortelius. This important atlas is also available from the BDH. The 18th and 19th centuries were a time of consolidation of an image that would not be completed until the 20th century. Jay Cook and Malaspina, among others, advanced with their explorations in the creation and understanding of the image of the world. The Spanish cartographer Tomas Lopez is worth mentioning. His work, digitized at the BDH, is a good example of this change of paradigm. Halfway through the 19th century, James Gall published a map that proportionally represented all the continents and was later popularized by Arno Peters, giving a very different image of the world from the one we knew. This is because the Peters projection tries to escape from the Eurocentric image of the world, maintaining the real surface of the countries, but modifying the forms and distances. We currently have access to the Earth in three dimensions, thanks to tools such as Google Earth, which offers us maps of the Earth from the combination of satellite images, aerial photographs, and geographical information systems in a three-dimensional globe. All these innovations are based on the 16th century Mercator projection. The question is, what will be the next turning point?